So I am curious to see whether are they green team or red team? They are green team, are going to be able to hold, you know, their own composure. I think that they're going to be the offenders here. They're going to be starting things off with a bang. Right as I say that, Venya opens up with a drop-down neutral air.
Absolutely. And this is one of those games where whoever takes that first suck is going to have so much momentum. Mars, obviously, a player. I think the best player in the world at playing ahead is this guy. Is once he's ahead, he's going to suffer. Oh, my gosh! You are dead! That was 20 seconds. What is this, a speed run? What are you doing? AGDQ was like a week ago. Okay, what are you doing? He's gone. But that's what I'm saying. Mars is one of the players that is, I think, the best in the world at playing ahead. Once he's ahead, he is going to make sure he stays ahead. And Mr. E, one of the most solid players as well, playing a Lucina, a character that's so good at playing behind or ahead. Let's be honest here. This character is nice.
Yeah, good character.
Okay, that character is a good character. But the forward air are going to take Mr. E off the side, unfortunately. But that's going to be the second stock coming in off the green team. Venya being the victim of that one. And Mars out here, Panic Globals.
He's untouched,
49%,
man.
Bro. That's light. Okay? All right, here we go. Chaining with these upwards, Greninja. We've seen Greninja take some names already in this tournament, in this top 16 so far.
Funnily enough, I've seen Mr. E go for some kind of overzealous edge guards, just running off with down air and that sort of thing, which he normally would never do in singles.
Oh no! Lives in a pineapple under the sea. Oh no, that sucks. But Mara's gonna be able to recover from that. You know what I'm saying? It happens. It's been a while since I've actually seen a pineapple. That's crazy. I used to see him all the time in Smash 4. I don't see him that much.
He went really out of his way to get pineapple.
Yeah. He actually, it's like are you trying to die? That's crazy. But regardless, 147% on Tilda here, 99% on Demise's own. But Mars sitting on a fresh stock here. Okay. Hitting into the 1v1 off stage. Yeah.
I don't think he could have tapped that. I think he was just launched at too high a velocity. And now blue team has a solid lead here. Oh, look at that combo, though. I think his partner got tangled up in that mess, though. I don't know if he has a jump. I love that upbeat to stage, knowing that his partner was there to help.
Wow.
And are they winning?
That was BOGO. Buy one, get one free on the up smash here, hitting both. Venya, that's what I was saying, man. Venya's so solid, but there's a boost kick. Stilettos, okay? We are talking nothing but damage right here. PG's Mars is trying to bring this back here for the blue team, but after that huge play from Venya.
Mars's parries have also been fantastic. Oh, that could be huge. He mashes out, and he actually manages to get it hidden on the way. This is super close. I do want to remind people, though, that Mars has not taken that much damage. His first stock ended up being he lost at around 40%. His second one, he was, I think, sub 100 when he got hit. So Mars has still been playing evasively so well. And as I'm saying that, I feel like he's taken more damage this stock than he has all game.
True.
At least in the thought of it. He's not nearly being as evasive as he was. He's definitely getting hit by these moves here and there, and that chip damage might add up, because one stray hit, and if he dies from that, that's going to be huge for blue team.
Beautiful off the downbeat, straight into the stilettos.
Wow.
Okay. These boots were made for walking. Let's go.
One goes down, then the other, just like that.
That was beautiful. Look at this again. Look at this. Beautiful. Watch this. The down B to catch the recovery off of the ledge. Beautiful. Normal getup getting caught. Off he goes. And then look at this punish. That was insane.
That wasn't
B.
even a punish. That was just he was catching him dropping shield. They were shielding in each other's face, right? Let me see this.
Look at this. He actually, look. He was just standing there, hit a button. He hit a button. I believe he was going for a down tilt right there.
Was that a down tilt or was that a jump? I can't even tell.
I think I saw the animation for a down tilt, I believe.
That means it was frames away.
Yeah, yeah.
Hold on a second. If down tilt connected, he could have gotten down tilt up smashed.
Yeah, but also Mr. E was there. So
Mr. E was there, but he might not have died outright.
No.
I'm saying there's an alternate timeline where ZSS up B is a little bit less fast.
But also, Mars is going to do that, right? Just to up B right in your face. Knowing that Mr. E's behind him to save him from anything. Only take a forward air. You'll be fine. But regardless, after a really scrambly game, as you're talking about, you're going to see a lot of clusters here in this game. Lots of very exciting gameplay, dynamic all across the board. But it will be Demise's Mr. E and PG's Mars taking game number one.
Ooh, okay, I'd say this is really a good barometer for the way this match might go. Green team has had a lot of stage control, and they've been managing to keep it. I wonder if that means that maybe they'll be more of, like, sort of a grounded approach in terms of like standing their ground. Getting stage control and really trying to get a lot off of that. Did he just tech out of his partner's up smash? Good awareness, I guess.
Okay, there goes Tilda taking a, I was about to say he was trying to make it back, but unfortunately he's going to get roadblocked right there by Mr. East forward air. Off the right side goes Tilda, and green team taking first blood once again. Or being the victim of it, rather. There's the grab. Off the right side, toss to his partner, straight into the forward air. Good stuff by Mr. E. Solid gameplay on the ledge here.
I like how he just throws it into the, you know, the mess that's going on to his left, you know? He's just like, probably chances are he's going to get hit by something over there. And then he's able to even capitalize off of it once he gets hit back.
Ooh.
Oh, charges up that forward smash, but good get-up option from Mr. E. And now this is 4 stocks to 6. Blue team looking like an even better position they were last game, especially because Morris has not pineappled so far. I don't know if he's going to do something like that again.
Yeah.
So
Mars is not one to make mistakes like that more than once, obviously. It is Friday. I'm assuming that the jitters are there. But Tilda and Davinia are playing exquisite here. But unfortunately, in this game so far, they are getting a little bit out-neutraled. The stage control coming in from the blue team, from Mars and Mr. E, is immaculate here. They're getting all the right hits at all the right times, all the right things in all the right places.
Oh, and that's
the
a broken
shield!
And he's keeping his partner safe, and he breaks Vanny's shield in the process.
You like that sequel, bro? Let me show you this movie one more time. That was first it was, you know what I'm saying? First that was Infinity War, then you saw Endgame. That was crazy.
That was also
whatever,
like,
whatever
I'll
it
save
takes.
You, friend.
Whatever it takes, 144% goes, demise zone, straight into the screen, back onto the Halo platform, and Mr. E trying to make it back here, trying to play the 1v1 while Mars on the left side still has yet to lose his first stock pass to LeBron here. Your shield!
And that's another stock gone. What was such a close game one? This game two is a blowout. Mr. E, we were saying that they were gonna possibly take the tournament. And this sort of teamwork, this synergy, this level of play, I am gonna stand by that statement. They are absolutely demolishing Vinny and Tilda right now.
Yeah, but Vinny and Tilda have brought that game number. You know what I'm saying? They were really close.
Ooh.
Oh, no. That might be what they need to get back into this game after solid play from Tilda and Davinia all game long. Let's not get it twisted. These guys have been playing well, but Mr. Ian Mars seem to be on a slightly higher level here.
That counter was so next level, and Mars was just next level.
Yeah.
Oh, that forward smash is going to be big. Mr. E, putting him there. He's alive. The tech's coming out from Tilda, doing a great job surviving. And if they can take out Mr.
Oh my, yeah, you cannot challenge that. But unfortunately, Davinia will fall. And now we have the blue team 2v1 up against Tilda here. So this is going to be really rough, especially for a character like Falco, not the most mobile, but the stilettos back air off the left side.
Definitely not as much of a one-sided match as I thought it was going to be. But nonetheless, that was sheer dominance from blue team. I think near the end, they started to take more risks.
Yeah.
Both teams started to take more risks. And I guess just in the end, being ahead to start, they ended up, you know, if you trade risks even for even, they're going to end up winning.
Absolutely. And